Hey guys, welcome back to Off the Wall Beauty. If you're new here, then welcome. If you're here and wondering why Anna isn't, then make sure you go back and watch the video titled First Impressions, I Tried New Things, something like that. I explain Anna's absence in that video. So, today I have something kind of exciting to share with you. Everyone knows about the Subculture palette from Anastasia. It's so pretty. You can see all the colors. They're mostly cool. And I don't know, they just really spoke to me, even with all the videos saying that it was basically a crap palette. You know, there was lots of stuff going around about this being a batch problem and that some batches were just like super powdery and had a lot of fallout and blah, blah, blah. Anyways, I've tried the palette. Yes, it is extremely pigmented. You like just barely tap your brush into a color and you'll get plenty of pigment. So like don't dig in there like you feel like you have to for some other palettes. And I have seen, I think Jackie Ina did a video on a dupe for the Subculture palette from Hush, maybe? I have found what I'm hoping is a dupe from a much more accessible brand, and this brand is at Ulta. It is from Makeup Revolution, and this looks so similar. I saw this in the store and immediately thought it looked like the Subculture. But let me show you the two next to each other. You can see they have very similar colors. And we're gonna find out how similar those colors are today. So I'm gonna do an eye look today. I'm gonna use the same colors or the similar colors from each palette. And I'm gonna do one eye with the Subculture palette and the other eye with the Makeup Revolution palette, which is called the Reloaded Iconic Division palette. So I'm really excited about that. As you can see, I already have on my foundation, my concealer, my eyebrows, and I just wanted to start with that because I'm feeling like doing something a little bit wilder today, and it required me to already have foundation on. I'm really inspired by a couple of images on Pinterest, and I will try to insert those pictures here. As you can see, they're very warm, they're very fall inspired, but they're also just a little bit editorial. Not something I wouldn't wear in public because like I've worn freaking blue polka dots on my eyes in public before. So I don't care what people think of my makeup, but not planning on going anywhere today. You can tell it is a little bit darker outside. It is only 4:30, it's not even 4:30 yet, and it's very dreary, it's a little bit rainy. It's windy, it's a little chilly, but that's fine, we just won't go anywhere. So let's get started with this eye look. I'm really feeling the more burgundy, kind of tealish look today, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do one eye in its entirety with the Subculture palette, and we're gonna see how that goes. But really quickly, before I do that, I want to put a little bit of powder under my eyes to hopefully catch any fallout that we get from this palette so that I can just wipe it away when I'm done. Also, if you're wondering about any of the face products that I use today, they will be listed in the description box. So I'm gonna really quickly kind of compare these two palettes side by side and try to figure out what colors I want to use for this eye look today. There is one difference. There is one more eyeshadow in the Makeup Revolution palette, which is this like really dark shade. It looks like it's black, but this shade is not in the Subculture palette. So I'm also kind of leaning toward playing with the orangey yellow colors. I never really do yellow, But I really want to step outside my comfort zone a little bit. I think I'm gonna play with the colors from Subculture. I'm gonna play with Axis, which is this really deep blue color, and New Wave, which is the orangey color. Maybe we could do a different color on the lower lash line, like maybe Destiny, this kind of foresty green. I'm just gonna see what happens. Let's just go ahead and do one eye. I've already primed my eye with the Tarte Shape Tape in Fair. I'm gonna go ahead and play with the Anastasia palette on one eye, and then we'll come back and we'll play with the Makeup Revolution palette on the other. So I'm feeling like I need to start with a more precise crease brush like the ColourPop E9. So I think I'm gonna start with New Wave, and I'm gonna put that right here. Like I said, you barely have to dip in here, like tap it off, and then go in with your shade. You wanna make sure you don't get too much on the brush, or you're gonna have way too much to work with. So I'm gonna kind of start in the center because that's where I want it to be the darkest, kind of right at the corner of my eyebrow there. And then I'm gonna blend that down my nose or into the hollow of my nose just slightly and into my eyebrow at the front. Going back in again, I wanna make sure you guys know I ain't cheating. And then again, focusing that in the center and then blending it under the brow just a little. And as you can see, this can get really pigmented pretty quickly. So you can already see how orange this is. And I really don't think that you should be scared of this palette because it's really not that pigmented if you work with a light hand. If you are inexperienced with super pigmented eyeshadows, then obviously you should not just dig in and go for it. You know? If you would rather not have to clean up a mess, then you should just start small and go from there. Okay, that's kind of cool. It kind of creates a cool little shadow there. Like that. And then I'm going to use the same brush for the Makeup Revolution side when we get there, but I'm going to clean it off first with a little like quick clean spray. So now I want to go in with a little bit of a fluffier brush. I think I'm going to use the Airbrush Blending Crease. This is from IT Cosmetics for Ulta. And I'm gonna go into Axis, which is this really pretty deep blue shade. And I'm going to focus this right on the outer corner to begin with, very similar to how I focus the orange really close to the corner of my brow. I'm gonna focus this first at the very edge of my eye, the very outer edge, and then blend it to where I want it to go. So we can pat it there. And then blend it toward the inner corner just a tad. I don't want to do too much at one time. Kind of want it to blend into itself a little. And then also onto the eyelid just a touch. And then I'm also going to flick this out a little bit into more of a V shape on the outer corner.
And then drag into the crease. keep blending until I get the shape that I want.
Okay, so I kind of like this. It's a little bit messy down here, but we can always clean that up with some concealer. So now I'm gonna take a clean crease brush and I'm just gonna blend the edges out of this blue a little bit more. I want this blue to be a little bit more diffused than the orange. I'm just gonna keep blending until I get the shape and the diffuseness, that's not a word, that I want. Yeah, you're gonna look crazy until your whole face is done, but like, who cares? It's just makeup. Like, you should be able to have fun with your makeup and not worry what other people think about the way you look, because who cares? I don't care. That's for sure. So I think I want to add another color into the mix of my eyes here. I'm just debating where I want to put it. I kind of want to put it between the orange and the blue a little bit to make it meet. It might get a little dirty, but we're gonna find out. And I'm gonna take a Real Techniques brush. This one is really pointed, so it can be really precise. And I'm gonna go in with Edge. And I'm just gonna kind of place this at the hollow of my eye right here is where I want this color to focus. And then I'm gonna blend it into this little crevice between the orange and the blue to try to blend those together. Okay. And I'm liking the way that looks without any extra blending. This is a very different look for me, but I really wanted to go a little bit creative since I'm not going anywhere today. For the lower lash line, I'm gonna smudge a little bit of Dawn under there first with a little bit of a bigger pencil brush, a little bit of a fatter pencil brush. This one is from e.l.f. It's their contour brush. And I'm going to use Dawn. And I'm gonna smudge that all along the lower lash line on this eye. And then from there, I'm going to get kind of a fat angled brush. This one is from Real Techniques. It's their brow brush. And I'm gonna go into Axis, which is that same blue color we were using earlier. And I'm going to run this just on the outer edge to blend the lower lash line with this blue that we have up here. And then to smudge it out, I'm going to go back in with my clean blending brush.
And just blend until it gets diffuse enough.
And then I'm still wanting to use some more of these colors because I really want to put the Makeup Revolution palette to the test. So I'm gonna go in with that foresty green Destiny right there. And I have two of these brow brushes, so I'm gonna use the other one that I have, the clean one with Destiny. And I'm gonna smudge that along the rest of the lash line. And again, going in to blend. All right, and then just to add a little bit of sparkle To the look, I'm going to go in with Electric, and I'm just going to use my fingertips because these shimmers don't work very well with a brush in my experience. So I'm going to use my fingertips with Electric, and I'm going to put that right here where I have a little bit of eye space left, just to add some shimmer to the look. And I'm not gonna carry this all the way to the crease because some of that blue is in the crease and some of that yellow is in the crease. I'm literally just gonna put it in the empty space here. And then I kind of also wanna put that on the inner corner. And I'm gonna use my finger and cube for the brow bone. Okay, so this is very different from what I normally do. I'm gonna go through and I'm going to repeat all of those steps with the Makeup Revolution palette. Okay, so with my clean ColourPop brush, the closest color to New Wave is this one down here in the corner. It looks duller than the one from the Subculture palette, but we're gonna keep our fingers crossed. So, and this does coat the brush pretty easily as well, though there's not as much kickback from the shadow. And again, focusing it here. Okay, I can already tell that this palette is not as pigmented, but maybe some people will appreciate that, you know, have the same kind of colors as the Subculture palette, but easier to work with generally. It is a little bit duller in color too. It's a little bit, it's a little darker. I can tell, maybe it's just the shadows from this light, but I can tell that this color is a little bit more vibrant from the Subculture palette than this one is giving me right now. But we're gonna keep going. And then the next color I did was the dark blue called Axis, and the closest color in the Makeup Revolution palette is this one right here. So, dipping into that. Again, not nearly as much kickback. And then focusing it. This one does start a little bit more pigmented than the last one, than that orange color. However, this one is kind of patchy. And it also seems just a touch different in color. Again, it's a little bit darker and less vibrant than the Subculture one. It's not blending as easily either. It's wanting to stick right here. All right, and I'm gonna go in with my clean blending brush and blend out the edges of that color. Honestly, so far I cannot say that I hate the Makeup Revolution palette. Even though it is a little bit duller, it's much easier to work with as far as immediate pigmentation. It's not as immediately pigmented. But we're gonna move on. So the yellow color from the Anastasia Subculture palette was called Edge. And the closest color in the Makeup Revolution palette is this one right here. It's really funny that all the colors I decided to use from the Subculture palette are like in this little corner here. So we're gonna go ahead and go in with this yellow color. I'm focusing this again in the hollow of my eye. Okay, so immediate impression of the yellow. The one from the Makeup Revolution palette is actually a little bit more vibrant than the one from Anastasia. A little bit brighter, and it's kind of keeping its color, whereas you can see this yellow on this side kind of blended with the orange. This one is keeping its yellow and it's not really turning orange like the other one did. This actually looks really good. I like this yellow a lot. The next step was to take our fatter pencil brush and place Dawn all along the lower lash line, and the closest color to Dawn in the Makeup Revolution palette is this color right here. So I'm gonna dip into that.
You can see there is some color coming off the brush, which is very similar to the Anastasia palette.
And then we need to take the Axis color, which is this one here, and place that on the outer edge of the lower lash line. And then blend that with a blending brush. I make this really weird face when I am blending on my lower lash line, and I really cannot help it.
Make a meme, I don't care.
And then we use that same type of brush, but a new one, with Destiny. And the closest color to Destiny is this green right here. And I'm placing this on the inner part of my lower lash line. And then again, blending that with our blending brush. That one wasn't nearly as pigmented as the subculture one, but that could be a good thing for some people. I'm just trying to blend the green into the blue a little bit. Okay, and then we need to go in with Electric on our finger. And from the Makeup Revolution palette, that would be this color right here, which looks a lot greener on camera, but we're gonna find out. We're taking that on our finger and placing that in the empty area on our eyelid.
Again, I'm not going all the way up to the crease. I'm just filling in the empty space.
Also using that on the inner corner. This color from this palette is a lot more just sparkle. There's not really any base color to it. The Subculture palette, Electric, has a little bit more of a green base instead of just being glitter, you know? And then finally, we used Cube on the brow bone, and that would be this color in the Makeup Revolution palette. So I'm gonna use my finger and tap that onto the brow bone. Huh. This one seems chalkier than the Subculture palette. So I'm just gonna go ahead and finish up my makeup look off camera. Okay, so I'm back and I finished my face makeup. I've gotta try to do this outro really fast because I'm running out of memory on my phone. So I'm gonna leave it up to you guys because I think that these palettes are really comparable. And I believe that the Makeup Revolution palette was only $15, whereas the Subculture palette is $42. So they definitely both have their pros and cons. Like I said, the Subculture palette is extremely pigmented. It can be a little powdery depending on what batch you get. I don't have a problem with the powderiness. It's really just like kickback. I didn't even get any fallout when I was doing this look today, so something to consider. The Makeup Revolution palette, on the other hand, you had to work with it a little bit more to get the pigmentation that you wanted. The colors, you know, they were either going to be a little bit more dull than the subculture palette, or they were going to be a little bit brighter, whereas the case of the yellow. If you want a shimmer that has a lot of color in the base, make sure you go with the subculture palette. I did find that the Makeup Revolution palette's shimmers didn't really have a very good base color. They just kind of were glitter, essentially. For my lips, I just used the Huda Beauty. Why is that always so hard for people to say? So, comment down below if there's a high-end product that you think I should find a dupe for. Like this video if you enjoy dupe videos. Subscribe to this channel so that you can keep seeing really cool content like this. I'm really trying to get out of my box, play with color, and play with some looks that I wouldn't normally do for myself. I'm really finding Pinterest is a great source of inspiration. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye! Of course, there's freaking tape on here. Throw the ideas at me. Just go ahead, throw them at me. I'm broke, and yeah, I can't just go buy things out of the blue for no reason. Why am I adorable?